Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
The proclamation of the Holy Gospel is according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
After entering a boat, Jesus made the crossing and came to his hometown. And there he brought to him a paralytic lying on a stretcher. When Jesus saw their faith, he said to the paralytic, "Courage, child, your sins are forgiven." And then some of the scribes and Pharisees said, "This man is blaspheming." Jesus knew what they were thinking and said, "Why do you harbor evil thoughts? Which is easier, to say your sins are forgiven, or to say, 'Rise up and walk'? That you may know that the Son of Man has authority on earth to forgive sins," he said to the paralytic, "Rise, pick up your mat, and go home." He rose and went home. When the crowd saw this, they were struck with awe and glorified God who had such authority to men. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
Good evening, my dear sisters and brothers. I love you all. There are two things we can learn from the Gospel. Una, our Lord was admiring the faith of those who carried the paralytic. You know? Kasi yung paralytic siyempre paralyzed, hindi makakamot na kayo Jesus. But this group, they brought the paralytic to Jesus to be healed. I know your organization ay parang ganun ba? You're going to the rural area, people, helping people. And ultimately, of course, when you help them, they will see the goodness of God in your work. Walang trabaho na hindi nakikita ng Panginoon, that's not rewarded. Sabi ni St. Paul, if you're generous, the Lord cannot be outdone in generosity. So, that's the point in the first part. And secondly, si Jesus, nakita yung paralytic, ang kailangan niya, para sinasabi, itong paralytic na ito, kung naniniwala siya that God is not angry at him, yung kanyang pagka-paralyze is not a punishment. But if he sees that he will be reconciled and believe that the Lord loved him and forgive him, then he will be healed. Kaya ang first word ni Jesus, "Your sins are forgiven." Sabi niya, "Please come home. Hindi galit ang Diyos. Please come." If you receive that message, you see, then he will be ill. Kasi kung minsan garantiin natin, kung tayo ng kasakit, kung tayo mayroong parusa ng Diyos. That's why when I had my sickness as cancer, I didn't see it as a punishment for me. Pwede pa rin purification, but I know the Lord has a good plan. So nangyari, itong paralytic kasi, kung minsan, para bang ayaw nang maging mahilig? Kasi kung ikaw ay paralytic, kasarap eh. Itukuhan ka, you have all the attention in life. Kaya kung isa, ayaw siguro may. That's why the Lord said, "Pick up your mat and walk." Nalala ko isang madre sa pinatulas. Pagkatapos, nakakasyon kayong kamay. Ay, hindi may kas. Dilatantam, "Ay, sister, anong nangyari sa kamay mo? Kawawa ka naman." So everybody, ay binababi siya. Kaya kung naglalakad, nakagam siya lagi. So ito, pinapakita na gano'n. But that was 1 year na, ay mong tanggalin. Sabi ko, parang gano'n paralytic. The Lord said, "Pick up your mat and walk." Very symbolical yan. Because yung mat ay ginagawa niya pag-relax, it's his past. No, yung past niya, palaging dala-dala yung past niya. So sabi, "No, don't let the past carry you. You carry your past." Kasi ang tendency natin, we blame our past. Eh, kapag-aral na yun eh. I know there's some people, they're blaming their parents, they're blaming their past. Imagine, "Oh my God, they're already dead. It's already past." Don't let your past carry you, but you carry your past. Which is very important, no? At tayo, di ba rin dito, group of clergy from Daisuk Ordaneta. And I give God talk about this. And then, kasi may mga pare na nag-transfer to the Yasuka Ordaneta or Daisuk in Gendaguban. Ang sakit ng loob nila doon si Bishop. Kasi, dala-dala na doon sa retreat. "No, God, I give this talk. Don't let the past carry you." So, "Oy, don't let the past carry you. Don't complain." We have to move on. You know? Sabi nila, "Pick up your mat and walk. So this is the brothers, these are the two things we have learned now, the gospel. Continue with your work. Nakikita na Jesus Christ because of your faith and your love. It's a noble job, helping people. And secondly, don't think na buti nagkasakit, it's a punishment. No, it's not a punishment. Kasi magkasal, makasalanan, okay. No, it's not the truth. So the Lord is saying sa'yo, your sins are forgiven. So pick up your mat